Konstantin Hering was a German physician and one of the important pioneers of homeopathy in United States of America. In the year 1800, Hering was born on 1st January at Rosatz of Saxony. He was the second child to his mother Christiane Friedrich and his father Karl Gottlieb Hering. His father was a famous musician and composer, teaching music to the children of pupils' school. Hering started his school education in the year 1811 at Classical School in Zittau. He joined the Surgical Academy of Dresden in the year 1817 and resumed his formal medical degree from the University of Leipzig in the year 1820. He continued his medical education at the University of Würzburg and completed his Doctor of Medicine in Surgery and Obstetrics in the year 1826. Hering had a passion and interest towards the learning of classical languages, Greek, mathematics, and he was much interested in collecting specimens of minerals, insects, animals, and plant herbariums. During the period of his medical education at Leipzig, he became the student assistant of a private lecturer named Robbie. Robbie was a former surgeon in Napoleon's army. At that time of 1821, the anti-homeopathic propagations were at the peak, where Robbie was approached by a publisher of Leipzig named Baumgartner, who wanted to publish a book against homeopathy and insisted Robbie to commit the work. But due to various reasons, Robbie handed over the task to Dr. Hering. Hering accepted the contract and started working on the anti-homeopathic book.
Hering eagerly started to write the book against homeopathy. His learning mind made Hering to study the literatures of homeopathy and Hahnemann for the purpose of making critiques on the system. In this due course, Hering came across a writing of Dr. Hahnemann in his preface of third volume of Materia Medica Pura. That is, the doctrine appeals not only chiefly but solely to the verdict of the experience. Repeat the experiments, it cries aloud. Repeat them carefully and accurately. You will find the doctrine confirmed at every step. And it does what no medical doctrine, no system of psyche, and no so-called therapeutics ever did or could do it. Insist upon being judged by the result. This made Hering more rational and he was ready to make the experiment on himself. At this moment, Hering was not aware that this is going to be a game changer in his career. Yes, Hering tested the cinchona experiment on himself and was surprised to see the truth behind the words of Hahnemann and principles of homeopathy. Hering was more convinced with the principles of homeopathy and dropped his commitment to write the book against homeopathy. And finally, one great decisive moment happened to Hering, which led him to become an ardent follower of homeopathy. It happened in the year 1824. One day, Hering received a cut wound in his right forefinger during a dissection of cadaver. The injury was very severe, which turned into a fatal gangrene, where Hering tried all orthodox medications, but nothing helped him. Finally, Dr. Kummer, a homeopathic friend of Hering suggested him the homeopathic medicine Arsenicum album, which cured his gangrene with few doses. And this gave Hering a most remarkable experience and decided to dedicate his life to advance this art of healing. Hering describes this in his words as, "The lost veil that blinded my eyes to the light of the rising sun was rent, and I saw the light of the new healing art dawn upon me in all its fullness. I owe to it far more than the preservation of a finger. To Hanuman, who had saved my finger, I gave my whole hand, and to the promulgation of his teachings, not only my hand, but the entire man, body and soul." And thus, Hering became a strong defender of homeopathy and started communicating with Dr. Samuel Hanuman. From the day of his conversion to homeopathy, Dr. Hering has contributed the best to the healing art. His first contribution was The Medicine of Future, the thesis of his MD in the University of Würzburg, in which he declared himself as a supporter of homeopathy. From the year 1827 to 1833, he worked for the King of Suriname, where he made zoological and botanical research works for the government. This gave him a chance to study more on animals and plants. He collected more specimens of plants and animals in this period. Later in the year 1828, Hering made the first trituration and dilution of Lachesis, the surucucu snake, and conducted a proving of it. This was one of the milestones in homeopathic drug proving. The domestic physician was another important work of Dr. Hering in the year 1835, which was published in two volumes. This was his only book specifically about basic therapeutics. Then he started the first homeopathic medical school in America, the American Academy of Homeopathic Medicine in Allentown, in the year 1835. And the same year, he published a pamphlet on necessity and benefits of homeopathy. The effects of snake poison in the year 1837 and suggestions for the provings of drugs in 1853 were other such contributions of Dr. Hering. He played a very key role in developing the Homeopathic Medical Society of Philadelphia in the year 1838. Hering published a book named The Logic of Homeopathy in the year 1860, and another work, The Translations of Gross Comparative Materia Medica, in the year 1866. And another most important contribution to Materia Medica was made in the year 1877 to 1879, that is, the condensed Materia Medica of Hering. And finally, one of the greatest contribution of Hering, which was completed by his students and fellow homeopaths after his death, that is, the 10 volumes of The Guiding Symptoms of Materia Medica between the year 1879 to 1891. The above said contributions were just a drop from ocean, and Hering has given so many wonderful contributions for homeopathy, as you can see them on the screen. Dr. Hering was a prolific writer and produced an impressive number of scientific publications. He was contributor, editor and co-editor of a great many journals where he published the ongoing results of his studies.
Hering is known for making numerous innovative contributions to the theory of homeopathy based on observations of both sickness and the healing process. His most well-known principle, the Hering's Law of Cure, argued that the body tends to seek the externalized disease, noting that symptoms would be visible as a part of the healing process.
The Hering's Law of Cure states the direction of cure as the disappearance of symptoms in a patient shall be in the reverse order of its appearance, from above downwards and from most important organs to least important organ. Dr. Hering continued his contribution to homeopathy medicine up to only a few hours before his death on July 23, 1880. His death was caused by a heart attack when he was working on the fourth volume of his work, Guiding Symptoms. The numerous honors he had received over the years give testimony of the high admiration he had achieved on both sides of Atlantic. He was famously called as the father of American homeopathy.